And welcome to the Knapp Medical Center postgame show, where it's a victory for your Weslaco East Wildcats, and they are going to the playoffs for the 17th time in 18 years as they move on beating the Donna North Chiefs tonight by a final score of 46-6. So a victory for your team, coach. So you got that momentum, two-game winning streak going into the playoffs as you looks like you're all playing against Edinburgh Villa.
Edinburgh Villa. You know, I want to change the subject before we get into the football. You know, I went out and voted the other day. I didn't see very many people out there voting. And remember, you guys make a difference in WISD land. If you want the new schools to keep up with the other schools, we need to do a lot of updates to our fine arts, our athletics, and to the schools itself. So get out there and vote. It's only pennies on the dollar for the year, and we need to make this happen. So hey, Eastside, let's get out there and show our support. Get out there, and I'm telling you, it's a good thing. You can trust me. Now let's talk about a little football. Yeah, we play Villa next Friday. We play over there at 7:30. Our kids are looking forward to it. You know, something that we built at Weslaco East is, you know, being in the playoffs every year. The last 17 years, we've been there 16 times. I'm proud of the kids, the way they battled this year. Like I said, last week we could have been district champs, but calls didn't quite go our ways this year, and you know, it was embarrassing, the two games that we lost with the officiating. But you know, it is what it is. We have to accept that and move on. I thought our kids battled hard, you know, led by Alex on offense, and we got a bunch of guys. You've seen Jediah coming on, you know, for only five games in his high school career. This guy is a D1 AA receiver.
Absolutely.
And he is something else when it comes to catching. And he's just learning the game. Angel had a touchdown. He's the other basketball kid on offense to come out. He's been great, being very patient for us to get him the ball. Pompa and Justin, two great running backs that's filled in for Devin, doing a great job. Julian, our tight end. Our freshman tight end, a great job. Our offensive line, they're getting better every week. I can see it. You know, we still make a mistake now and then, but, you know, they play really hard. And our defense tonight, they should have thrown a shutout. I was disappointed in the coverage we was in on third and long. We got out of that coverage, and you've seen second half, we shut them out. So we've got a lot of things to improve in a week and get ready for Villa.
And that chemistry between Alex Martinez and Rivens is just getting better and better every game, and they didn't. Villa didn't see that matchup last time.
Well, you know what's good about it is at Weslaco East, we are multi-sport athletes, and Jediah said many a times that he wished he would have been out a long time ago, and so do I. But you know, you look at Zeke, Coach Rodriguez. He's going to have Alex. He's going to have Jediah. He's going to have Zion. He's going to have Angel. He's going to have all those guys in basketball. So you know, we think cross country went and finished 13th at the state meet. We think our basketball team's going to compete not only for a district title, make a playoff run. Our baseball team's there. So, you know, Weslaco East is a place that is, if you want to play sports and you want to be a multi-athlete sport, come on over. That's one thing we guarantee you.
Coach, so as you mentioned, 16 years out of 17 making the playoffs. You know, we've had numerous conversations about it, but just what is the secret sauce to your program in being consistent?
I really think Gamboa, he runs a great school, a very disciplined school, a great leader, getting Dr. Rivetta back, a leader of the community. I think the coaches, assistant coaches I have, and the kids bought into a system. They bought into a system that is a tough system. And, you know, I love the kids at Weslaco East. When I retire, I'll never forget the kids. I can tell you that. The kids that come through here, they've given me their all, and it shows on the field. And I appreciate the kids, their parents, and all the fans that we've had for the run that we've had.
You've had some great players. I mean, Bobby Gonzalez, Eric Mugia, we go on and on down the line. Pedraza, Lefever, and J.C. Vargas, Ramsey.
Lupe, I mean, so Quates, yeah, there's been a lot. And, you know, this Alex, and I said it last week, I know we didn't win district on the record-wise, but I guarantee you, there's nobody in our district that's done more for a team than Alex Martinez. Went over 1,000-yard rushing, probably sitting around 1,400 yards passing, and he's carried this team on his back. I hope the coaches out there do the right thing this year, because he is the MVP of our district.
I think one of the things that you guys take pride in, Coach, that started from day one since you guys arrived here at Weslaco East, was that powerlifting program. That kind of set the foundation to success in not only football but in other sports there. You guys still stand by it, don't you?
Yeah, we're hoping to get back up there and win a title. It's been a while. Coach Guzman, if you're watching, I blame you. Coach Guzman and me has been through three boys' state titles and two girls together. I miss him. He's a brother of mine. You know, we really think this year we got a chance with the girls, Coach Gomez. But we want to get our boys back up there strong again. That way we can compete with anyone. You know, Coach Guzman and PSA played for a district title today at 6A, and we beat both those guys. So that tells you what kind of team we have. We've gotten nicked up a little bit, but, you know, we're going to bounce back. And, you know, you talk about Vela. Vela's probably the most successful program the last 7-8 years besides us. And Coach Campbell is probably one of the best coaches in South Texas I've ever faced. And, you know, I think he's going to have his team ready. I know he will. Like I said, just a great individual and a great coach, and his players play so damn hard.
What about the passing game this year, Coach? I know you've had years in the past where you've had great passing, but you hear this time it seems like you just have more receivers for Alex to choose from. How has his passing game evolved?
Well, you know, he worked hard this summer going out there throwing to these guys, and, you know, 7-on-7, I hate it. I lost a heck of a player 7-on-7. He broke his leg. He's back playing now, but it took him forever. And I hate 7-on-7. I think it messes up the receivers. I think it messes up the quarterbacks. Coaches argue with me, but you can't jam receivers. There's no pass rush.
There's no tackling.
Yeah, there's no tackling. So, but I tell you what, Alex worked hard on and getting the ball out, you know, and he's from this time last year to now, he's the most improved player I think I've ever coached.
Well, Coach, going back to Edinburgh Vela, you guys gave them a run for their money over there. That's probably one of the better games that y'all have played all season long there. So you must feel pretty good about your chances in this rematch here in the playoffs.
Well, whether we play Vela, PSA, North, McAllen Memorial, or Mackay, I never go into a game thinking I'm going to lose. Never. You know, if it happens, it happens. But, you know, our kids believe in themselves. They believe in my coaching staff, and they believe they got a lot of pride. So we're going to go over there. We're going to give it our best. And if we move on, we move on. If we don't, my hat's off to Vela. But we're going to try to bring our A game and try to win a game.
All right, Coach. Congratulations. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Thank you, guys. Remember, get out there and vote.
Yes, sir. All right. That's Coach Mike Burgett. Going to the playoffs once again, Mike. And, yeah. You know, we had the players here from that first team that won back in 2003. They went 1-10. And then there was a couple of lean years, but, you know, they improved year in and year out. And then they just went on a tear. Armando Cuellar came in and became the coach, and he won some district championships, went 3 deep. And then Burkett took it to another level, and they've just been on a tear. I mean, you called Weslaco East the team of the decade from 2010 to 2020 because of all the success that they had.
Well, and I stand by that statement, to be honest with you, Carlos. Yeah. I know there are a lot of great teams out there, like Sherryland, Edinburgh Vela had a lot of great teams, but just when you talk about consistency and you talk about winning district championships and you talk about winning playoff games, well, Weslaco East was right there for many, many years, and they've continued it here in the 2020s here. I mean, even though they didn't win district this year, they still made another play. They clinched another playoff spot, and they're ready to go up against Edinburgh Vela. And we saw Cardinals in 2016 pull off one of the biggest upsets in school history. A big win there, and I mean, I know they're not surprised by it, but it was a big-time win for Wesco ISD, for WISD, and I know they're going to bring their A game. They almost beat him in non-district, so I'm very excited for them. I think they're going to come out ready to play and give them a great game.
They haven't seen Jediah Rivens. They haven't seen him. He didn't get to
great
play
point.
In that game.
That's a great point.
And so it's not the same team that they played, you know, early on in the season. Vela's not going to be the same team either. They're both going to be much more improved, you know, especially this time of the year. It's going to be a phenomenal game to watch those two teams play.
And momentum-wise, you got to feel really good. I mean, they won, what, the last three or four games of the district play there, so they're playing really good football right now. As you mentioned, Alex Martinez rolling. He's developed that chemistry with Chaverin Rivens, and the running game is still there, even though they had some injuries there at that position there. They're still running the football very, very well. The defense is still playing lights out. Special teams, we have one of the best kickers in the Rio Grande Valley in Pedro Espinosa. So if it comes down to a game-winning field goal, you know you have a reliable kicker, Carlos. So, hey, man, why not?
Well, please. Texas football is going strong right behind me because it is senior night here. So the seniors from Weslaco East, they're on the field behind me. They had a chance to walk the 100 yards, and then they sprinted back. They ran back. It was quite a sight to see, and then they just finished watching a presentation on the scoreboard. So fun times happening right now at Bobby Lackey Stadium with the Weslaco East Wildcats in the senior class. It's November, so they have a lot more traditions, like Coach Burgett was talking about. They have basketball season, and they plan to be successful with basketball and then all the spring sports as well. Let's go to the highlights in this game. We want to give some people some credit, and let's see what happened. It started off here in the first quarter. Alex Martinez taking this one 13 yards down the field, and the Wesco Panthers go for two. Sorry, the Wildcats go for two, and it's 8-0. And then the defense, we talked about how much they have improved, and it is Andrew Vasquez with the interception right there for the Wildcats. Still in the first quarter, and Rivens with the catch, spinning around, breaks tackles, and look what he does right here.
Wow.
Coach Burgett says that he's a college football player. It makes it now 14-0, Weslaco East. And then here we go. Donna.
Wow.
With a great catch. The young man from Donna North making that catch right there. That was a great catch for him. Second quarter, Alex Martinez running with the football again. Second touchdown of the night for him. 11 yards, making it 22 to East there at the half. Third quarter now. Rivens, watch this. Over the defender, he makes the catch, keeps one foot in bounds. 29-6, Weslaco East, and this offense is just rolling here. Justin Gomez with a football for Weslaco East. And here we go, in for the score, making it 35-6. Wildcats with the ball. Then Moore, catch right there. That's number 17. Angel Cubarrubias with the catch. He goes in. And then how about Gomez one more time? The second touchdown of the game, making it 43-6 at that point. And the Wildcats win this game by a final score of 46-6. They back in the playoffs once again. And it looks like, you know, they're playing Hardin to South won tonight. They beat Donna, so they're playing against Edinburgh Vela.
Yeah, we forgot to mention Gomez, Carlos. He's come on strong the last few weeks for Wesco East in the backfield. You know, what the loss of Devin Cantu, that's a player that stepped up. And Margarito Pompa playing excellent football. And, I just admire, Carlos, the way Alex Martinez plays quarterback. You see the patience, the way he is in running the offense there when he runs that quarterback keeper, how patient he is. He follows his blockers and just finds the hole, attacks, and then oftentimes scores a touchdown there. It's really good to see a player like that just run that offense.
Man, we saw those top plays.
Yeah.
We saw those top plays earlier during our pregame show, and there was just one play where Alex is running down the field. He just fires it down like a frozen rope to Rivens and the catch. So this passing offense, Mike,
right.
We've seen passers. We've seen people. They've had some great quarterbacks, but I don't think we've seen it to this level.
Well, I mean, That play you're talking about, Carlos, was kind of thrown toward the sideline, and then Rivens had to kind of get it and maintain his concentration, bring the ball in, and put one foot in bounds. And so those guys just have excellent chemistry, considering they've only played together for about five or six games here. It's just very scary. It really is very scary going into the playoffs there. And so, yeah, and then I know they have other weapons at wide receiver, too. I mean, number 17.
Julian Garcia.
Skyler Perez, Carlos, another player that has made big catches throughout this season. So, you know, it was like we talked about in the pregame, Carlos. So we had guys that had to come in the middle of the season, some newcomers that had to come in and make plays, and they haven't missed a beat. They're still making plays.
All right, we'll go ahead and wrap it up here. The Western Coast Wildcats in the playoffs. They'll be playing at Edinburgh Friday night against Vela. It'll be the first round of the playoffs. The bi-district championship is on the line for West Loco East. All right, for Mike Gonzalez, I'm Carlos Robledo. Once again, the final score, Western Coast wins it by a final score of 46-6. Thanks for joining us here on the Knapp Medical Center Postgame Show.